So I'm debugging a WPC PowerDriver board, and I note that transistor Q32 is turned on all the time. You can see in my test rig. So I've done a little bit of testing. I just wanted to show you how to use a logic probe to track this down if it goes all the way back to a piece of integrated circuit silicon. So Q32 is pre-driven by Q31. And it goes back to pin 12 of U3, which should be a copy of pin 13 of U3. So just quickly here, here's Q32. I'm gonna put my logic probe on the tab so you can see it's grounded now, unlike every other transistor on this board. Q32 is grounded. And I've tested the pre-driver. It's too hard to do that with one hand and a phone in my hand. So I'm going to go back to pin 12, which is the output of U3. And you can see that it is stuck low. And pin 12 should be the mirror of pin 13, or a copy of pin 13. And you can see pin 13, which is D7 from the MPU, is pulsing like it should. Just for giggles, let's check pin 15, which is another output. So 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, and it's solid high, as it should be, because that solenoid's not supposed to be pulsing right now. I've got the Q32 circuit pulsing right now, flasher 8. I can show you how to get help information too while I'm at it here. I just press the credit button, and the WPC software will scroll through all the important information for that particular drive circuit. So I knew this is Q32. So I'm going to take U3 out and replace it, and we'll see what happens. So I've taken that 74LS374 at U3 out, and I have it in my Chinese chip tester. And then you can see it was reading ERR. Let me shade that a little. So that chip is most definitely bad. And we are back with the CPU, or the driver board, that had blown U3. I have cleanly removed it, installed a quality 20-pin dual wipe socket, and installed a LS374 from my stock. Again, I'm driving this from a WPC DMD test ROM. Here is your unregulated 12, your regulated 12, and your 5 volts. All good enough. Lamp matrix operating correctly. And you'll note that solenoid 24, which is Q32, is not locked on. So let's put it into test. And we'll do solenoid test just to make sure I didn't honk something up along the way. And good news, solenoids are working. Let's get to the flashers where we had a problem before. I'll get it on running. Moment of truth, and bingo! Looking good. Let's test the GI. All strings dimming correctly. I did have to use the solder stitch technique on J115. You can kind of see it in there because the header was so burnt. There is no other alternative. Lamp matrix working, and let's do lamps and flashers just because this is my favorite test. And we are working correctly. So that is it. All of the anomalies that you were noticing with this board have been corrected. I've changed C2, C4, C5, and I put a blocking diode in at the bottom of R224, which is designed to prevent the explosion of C11 when a connector is put on in the wrong place. And of course I've changed the GI headers and all the power headers. This one took an extra one. J104 was quite roasty toasty, so I changed it also. So it's good to go now. Well, let me show you the latest addition to my bench here. You can see I've got this computer. It's called the SCE, and it's in the normal position right now. You can see it looks like it's kind of locked up, or it's moving pretty slow. It's probably running Windows. So let's switch to AUGs. There we go. Now we're talking. Now we got some CPU horsepower going. Thanks, folks.